Good morning everyone. Today we are going to discuss about the concept of volume. Students are facing a lot of problems regarding the volume. We are having a basic formula of volume by which we can learn easily the concept of volume of different shapes. Firstly, I want to start with the basic concept of volume. What is the basic formula of volume? That is area of base multiplied height. You can see on the board it is written area of base multiplied height. By this basic formula, we can learn the formula of volume of different shapes. Let me start with the first shape, that is cuboid. Cuboid. In cuboid, can you tell me what is the area of base of cuboid? Yes, the cuboid's base is rectangular. So, the area of base will be? Yes, area of rectangle. What is the area of rectangle? Length multiplied breadth. Yes, when length multiplied breadth, it will multiply by its height. Then we got the volume of cuboid. It means area of base multiplied height. Same pattern we can use in cube. Yes, cube. What is the area of base of cube? That is a square. A square will multiply by a because in cube the height is a. A square multiply a, that is equals to a cube. So the volume of cube is a cube. Similarly, we can understand the concept of volume of cylinder. In cylinder, what is area of base? Area of base is circular. It means pi r square. Pi r square multiply by height, we got pi r square h. It means it is very easy to understand the volume's concept. By which method? Area of base multiply height. We learn the three volumes of cube, cuboid and cylinder. Now the fourth one is related with cylinder. Volume of cone. The fourth concept is of cone. Volume of cone is equal to 1/3 volume of cylinder. It means we can say the volume of cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. But in what condition? When the cone and cylinder are of same radius and same height. I want to show you a picture. Suppose this is cylinder and I am having a cone which is of same radius and same height. This is h. This is h, this is r, and this one is also r. If the cylinder and cone are of same radius and same height, in that condition we can interrelate the volume of cone and volume of cylinder. Volume of cone is equal to 1/3 volume of cylinder. What is volume of cylinder? We already learned pi r square h. So the volume of cone will be equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h. Now there is turn of next figure. The next figure is sphere. Sphere. The volume of sphere is also related with cylinder. How? The volume of sphere is equal to 2/3 volume of cylinder. But again there is a condition that the height of cylinder and the diameter of sphere should be same. And the radius of cylinder, radius of sphere, again there should be same. How? I want to show you a picture. This is a cylinder which emerges a sphere. Now you can see that the height of cylinder is equals to the diameter of sphere and they both are having same radius. Sphere as well as cylinder, both having same radius. In that condition we can say the volume of sphere is equals to 2/3 volume of cylinder. Now what is volume of cylinder? That is 2/3 pi r square h. Instead of this h, we know this h is diameter of the sphere. So this h is equal to 2 times of its radius. If h is 2 times of its radius, instead of this h, we can write 2r, that equal to 2 by 3 pi r square into 2r. Instead of h, I am writing 2r. That 2 will multiply with this 2. It will be 4 by 3 pi r cube. We can see with the help of cylinder, we learn the volume of sphere. And the last one, that is hemisphere. Volume of hemisphere is half volume of sphere. Yes, the volume of hemisphere is half of volume of sphere. Now what is volume of sphere? That is 1 by 2, 4 upon 3 pi r cube. So 4 upon 3 pi r cube will change into 2 by 3 pi r cube. By one basic formula, volume of volume is equals to area of base multiply height. We can learn or we can interrelate all these formulas. I hope this method will definitely help you to learn the concept of volume. Thank you very much to all of you.